The focus of the puzzle. You ask me a lot in puzzle, right?
So, you have puzzle. One is a puzzle and A is a puzzle. Similar to the case example that I gave, right?
Yeah.
One puzzle and then four is a puzzle. Here we have A is a puzzle. So, for both cases, then the distribution of number of cases that require each number of hashes. So you can compare what is the number of hashes you need, like we have in the previous lecture, right? In puzzle, we have, so the first case, one is a puzzle, you have one line and another, you have another line, you compare what is the number of cases. At a 10, how you can obtain this distribution? Not just copy from someone, not just fill by yourself. So. A graph for distribution, you see the graph in the lecture notes. So you should draw that kind of graph. Average number of hash updated. Know how to compute this? For each case, puzzle A and puzzle B. So recall about examples. So you remember you have in our lectures we have what we have first is the case of force, one single form, right?
Yeah.
One single form. And another is K equal to 2. But they're form. So what is the number of hashes for the first one? The maximum? 16. So how you compute the average number of hashes you know? Okay, you failed. You remember the lectures?
Average is 2 to about k minus 1.
No, another fail. Any idea? The average? What you get in the lecture is 8.5. How can you get 8.5?
Plus half. No, plus half.
Yeah,
you
think
you got
it too. Yeah, that's not correct. Average, just average. In the case of this, you have 10. Why you have 10? Because for every sub-puzzle, you have maximum 4. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 over 4 equals 2.5. And you have 1, 2, 3, 4 sub-puzzle, you have 10. Okay? So this is how you get in the lecture notes. And you can apply the same method for the assignment. The standard question? Yeah, the question. Standard deviation. You know how to compute it. Computer.
Yeah.
You can put it to the
extra amount. Got formula. Some average.
So they have
four. That's so shit.
can't hear you in this situation is 16. And N minus 1 is 15. And X bar here is the average, is 8.5. XI here is the XI that you know. So just put into the formula and you compute, and then you can find the standard deviation. Okay? So standard deviation. Go online, you'll see the formula, and then just compute it. Easy? You type standard deviation and you find a lot of place where it might differ. Yeah, they have a lot of examples as well, so I think they should have an example for you. Yeah, this is one. Or anyway, you can try it yourself. So this is the first question. Clear, huh? The second is you do yourself. The four questions. Respond your own unspecific distance of insider, placing malware within the system. You satisfy the type of malware plays, blah 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 blah. This is how you can find information in a book, lecture, or internet. Try to do it. I will come back to the question three later. Question five is how you compute the spread of worms, right? So every hour, the worm spread from each affected computer to one uninfected computer. So you should give a table showing the number of infected computers of each at each hour across 24-hour period. So time t equals to zero, the affected computer equals to n equals to one. Okay. So if time equals t equals to one, then what is the infected computers? Sure. So at this time, t equals to zero, there's one computer affected. And every 1 hour, it can affect another computer. So go to 1 hour, then how many computers is affected? Two. Right? Because there's one and this can affect another one. So at this point they have two. There's another hour. How many? I don't know. Okay. So you know when how to do it. So this is how you can get another just also saving the way of okay. Thinking. And you should draw the table of computing it. Okay. Come back to question three. This is somehow you need to do with Bayes theorem. I give you one example. So this is a theorem about how you compute the conditional probability. So assume that I have event A and event B. So really what it say is the probability that the event A happened, given that the event B happened. It calculated by this formula. This is the probability of B happen, given A happened. Probability that A happened and probability of B happened. So basically, you think about this maybe like B is the event of bomb attack. That's the bomb attack in our university. A is the event of having a car. So what is the probability that even have a one, that we still have a class if there's a bomb attack?
Zero.
Yeah, so this is what does it mean. And I will give you examples. Maybe you come back to this in the lab, but maybe not yet. So, and this is what we do in the lab in Volvo. So this is one example that you see how the Bayes theorem will work. So for example, you want to, you go to the hospital, you want to check whether you get the disease or not. Okay? And the doctor say that, okay, you got the disease. So what is the probability that even though you get a paper saying you are dying in 5 days, that you are still well? What is the probability that even getting those paper from doctor saying that you have a disease, but you are very well, you have no disease at all? Yeah, for positive? Okay, so this we can compute via this example. Okay, look at this example. Assume that the test is accurate up to 87%. Meaning that if you get a disease, then 87% the test will correct that you get disease. And if you are well, then 87% say that you will serve. The incidence of disease is 1% in population. Say, in the population, just 1% of people to have this disease. Okay? Okay, so this is the probability. This is the probability that even you get a positive paper or test saying that you get a disease, what is the probability that you get well? So this is, if you consider in the formula there, you can consider system of event B, event A. So the formula tells you that the best formula tells you that the probability of A given B equal to probability of B given A have probability of A divided by probability of B. Moreover, this can be written more because the probability of B can be written more in a
B, even A bar, probability of A bar.
Yes. So A bar here is the complement of A. Okay? So if A happened, then A bar not happened. A complement. The complement of it. Okay? So where on and where are complement? And probability of A plus probability of A bar equal to 1. So this basically, what's the formula, the Bayes theorem tell you how to compute it? So come back to this, if you consider well at A, B at the positive test, then you can represent it in term of, you see, probability of A even B equal to probability of B even A times probability of A. And probability of B, then you can write a probability of A given B, B given A, times probability of A, probability of B given A bar means unwell. A is well, so A bar unwell, and times probability of unwell. Okay, so this is the formula and how you compute it. You have only two numbers, 87% is accuracy, and 1% in the population, the incident in population. So probability of well is 99%, because only 1% got disease. So 99% don't get disease, so 99% is well. Another is, if you are well, you got a positive test, then this is 13%. Because if you are well, so you should get a test saying that you are well, mean negative test, 87%. So that means well, if you are well, you get a positive test saying that you get busy, should be happening with 30% because of accuracy. So similarly, this is, put it here because it's the same as here. So here, probability of unwell is 1% of population. Given that you are unwell, and the test said that you are well is the accuracy test, so this is 70%. So computing, you give you nearly 94%. Okay? You go to doctor. Doctor said that you are getting a disease, but 94% you are well. So what should you do? You sue the doctor. I'm kidding. Okay? So the thing is, this is somehow we call the failed test in statistics. And it's very depend on what we call the base rate, is 1% of population here, and also depend on the accuracy test as well. So the accuracy test here is only 87%, and the base rate is very, very small. Very small. So that's why even though you get a positive test, then you should not believe on it. Because 94% you will be very well. Okay, so this is just an example of how the Bayes theorem can apply to this situation and to compute this kind of probability. And so you may use it in the assignment. So this is basically what you do. Okay, then another one, and you have a question six. Question six tells you about here you can find information online, and then you read it, and you just briefly describe how. should be strong enough. Again, submission day is 25th, midnight. Don't try to submit in the last hour. 1 minute late or 1 second late, 20% deduction. 25. Okay, so including the day over the weekend, so be careful. And it costs you 12% of your final mark, right? The first assignment is 14, this one is 12, and the next one will be 14. The next one is the assignment 3 is working in group. 14.
Any
questions?